Oh, look, swans. Look. Good morning, internet. It is 8:30 in the morning and welcome back to the channel. I'm having a very nice healthy breakfast here in the morning sun. The tent is still a little bit damp from the outside from morning dew, so I'm just waiting for that to dry a little bit and then I'm gonna pack up everything and then hit the road. It's so nice to have a breakfast outside in the sun. And last night I watched a beautiful sunset on the beach, which was really amazing. So this gives the whole camping experience, makes it totally different when you have nice weather actually. After I finish my breakfast, I'll show you on the map where I am, because I promised that, and where I'm gonna go today. Alright, let me show you on the map what's going on. It's not visible so well, this map, because it's quite big and I couldn't find a better map. So we'll have to work with this one. I came off the boat from Iceland back here, and yesterday I first went on the highway and then I took some back roads over here, and now I am here, right on the coast. And the plan for today is to ride to this area. So I'm going to ride close to Copenhagen, the capital of Denmark, which is over here. And from there you can just ride into Sweden. So I was planning to actually take the boat from Hirtshals to Norway, but yeah, because they now have a 10-day quarantine upon arrival in Norway, I skipped that, unfortunately, because this is super beautiful. So yeah, I go to Sweden instead, and well, that's a little bit easier because I can just drive there. I think I forgot to say that the total distance of today is about 350 kilometers. It is a hot day. I'm already sweating now. Total opposite problems from Iceland. No, I think it's going to be a beautiful day. And I don't have a lot of super interesting sites planned for today. I think there's one castle which I'm going to visit. But other than that, it's just going to be riding nice back roads, hopefully. And just really enjoy a day on the bike with blue skies. Now everywhere they harvested. A few weeks ago it was all still standing on the land. Maybe if there are some Danish people watching, they can explain to me what strip means. Does it mean village? Because almost all the towns here, they end with strip. So I'm starting to think that means town or village. I'm going to the Egeskov Godskontor. Ah, no drones. That's a shame. I don't know how to get to the castle. Maybe if I'm here. do I park, actually? Where do all these people park their cars? I think I came from the wrong side. Hi. Where do I have to park? I came from that side.
You have to go all the way.
All the way back?
Back.
Yeah?
Up in the front to the main road and twice right. Then you come to the front gate. Come from?
From the Netherlands.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's right. Just you?
Yeah. Just me. Thanks. Okay, let's have a look what this Egeskov is all about. Here there's another sign. No drones. Quite a massive terrain. I am now here. And I want to see this very nice place. So they have the castle here. And then but they also have all these gardens, look. And there we are. Ah, look, swans. Look. That really fits. I think having swans here in the pond. So anyway, this is the Egeskov castle, and this is the best preserved moat castle in Europe. And moat refers to that water that is around it to protect it. And now it has a private owner, and it's a really quiet place. But it was built in 1554, mainly as a defense structure in time of political or religious unrest. Now you can also go inside, but I decided not to do that because I don't know how busy it will be inside, so I will just stay outside. Time for a break. It's around lunchtime, so I decided to have a lunch here, sandwich. Yeah, I just realized that coming from Iceland to here, it is almost a 30 degree temperature difference. Just, yeah, such a huge change, but I'm liking this. Let's continue the ride. It's another 150 kilometers to where I'm planning to stay tonight. This is nice. So, the tent is standing. I'm the only one camping here. I think, pretty sure it's allowed. It's really quite nice because there's like these benches so I can have a dinner. I have one of these bags. They fit 4 liters, so it's quite helpful. And then if it's empty, then it hardly takes any space. And then I have my drinking bottle, which has a water filter in it, so that way I can drink pretty much anything without having to worry to get sick. Oh, it was such a relaxed day. Nothing really spectacular, but it's just, I don't know, I have a feeling that Denmark is just like that, you know. It's not extremely spectacular, but it feels so laid back and relaxed and calm, idyllic. I just like it. Anyway,
thank you.
I can have my dinner here, sitting on a table. Tonight on the menu is another soup, curry soup this time. Oh, I better steer this. This is going a little bit fast. It's going really fast. Wait, wait, wait. So that's the curry soup, and then I have some nice bread with hummus. So that is going to be dinner for tonight. So yeah, that was it for today. I really hope you liked this video. If you did, please give a big thumbs up and subscribe down below. And then I'll see you in the next video. And then I'll be riding to Sweden. So see you then.